My name is David Zakuszewski. Everybody calls me Nick. I moved to New Jersey in November to retire. My wife and I built a brand new house and just in trying to enjoy life. And then it happened. I got diagnosed with pancreatic cancer. I was visiting my son for Christmas, and a couple days later, my son tells me I'm turning yellow. So we go in to see my wife, Debbie, and we decided that since we're up there, we went to my family doctor and I got blood work done. And then we were coming home back to Delaware on Thursday. My wife and I, we went shopping on Friday. I get a phone call from my doctor and tells me, get yourself to the emergency room ASAP.
So we went, we dropped our stuff and we went to Bayhealth. And and that's how it basically started. After the emergency visit, of course, they did lots of testing. They did everything that you can possibly imagine. In my heart, I knew it was pancreatic cancer because there wasn't any pain.
Found out that the canal that releases the bilirubins was being blocked by a tumor. Dr. Mahendraraj came into my room, introduced himself, and told me, don't worry about a thing.
In early January, I was driving home and I got a call from one of the internists letting me know that they had a consult for a patient with pancreatic cancer, or what looked like pancreatic cancer at the time. We didn't have a diagnosis. I pulled up Nick's scan, took a look at it, and was also informed that, you know, he was a little bit uncertain as to the diagnosis and he was planning to leave the next day. I had a good idea of what was going on inside Nick's body from my experience dealing with this disease for so many years. So I actually turned the car around and just went into the hospital to meet with him, just to talk to him. If nothing else, I feel that cancer is a disease of the body, but more so of the mind as well. When a patient is stressed, anxious, uncertain, afraid, it really doesn't help with the healing process. It really doesn't help with that motivation which is going to get them through the disease. So it's very important for me to have a conversation with the patient to make them understand what this could be. And more importantly, to let them know that there's someone here who will get them through the entire process. So I went in that night, I met with Nick. I talked to him about what I think this is based on the blood work, based on the imaging, and based on my experience. We didn't have a diagnosis back then, but I was fairly confident that this was pancreatic cancer we were dealing with and that we should be prepared for that diagnosis.
As we were driving home, my husband said to me, so what do you think? I said, I think we're gonna let him do the surgery. I think this is it, you know? Do you wanna go for a second opinion somewhere else? I said, absolutely not. I think this is it. This is who we want. And I did ask him, you know, why did you come here? Why were you in Delaware? Why did you come to Delaware? You were in New York, you were in Florida. Where, you know, why here? And he turned around and he said, because they need me. Special.
Pancreatic cancer is one of the most deadly cancers one can have, and the treatment of it is very, very difficult. A lot of times patients don't have any option other than chemotherapy, but for a very small subset of patients, surgical therapy offers the only cure for pancreatic cancer. The operation is called a pancreaticoduodenectomy, or as you might have heard, a Whipple procedure. As you can imagine, this is a pretty complicated operation with a complicated course after surgery, and one has to be very equipped to deal with these complications as well as offer the surgery and the post-operative care throughout the patient's recovery.
I am the first robotic Whipple surgery at Bayhealth. And, you know, I can't thank him enough. The Whipple is definitely a benefit to the point of you're not opened up too much. Like, I've got a total of 6 incisions, and they're all maybe about an inch and a half incisions.
In Nick's case, we were able to combine the two, the minimal invasive nature of a robotic operation with the technical demands of a Whipple operation in what has become Delaware's first robotic Whipple.
There's just no, I don't know what to say. It was just a wonderful operation and procedure.
A lot of my training was in very complicated and complex cancer cases, and I'm committed to bringing this kind of care to our patients here in Delaware.